Well, let's look at some of these forces again. Now, when we looked at it previously, we used a lot of cosines and a lot of sines, and that can be very difficult for some of you to actually work through and easy to get confused with. There's a little trick to making this somewhat simpler to solve for, and that's reorienting your axes.
So rather than taking the whole idea of y being vertical and x being horizontal, what if we took the perspective of the guy on the sled? What if we chose, from his perspective, y being up and x being down the incline? We'd have to take our x and y and rotate them by a certain amount, say an angle theta, so that they line up in this new direction. So our new y points perpendicular to the incline. Our x points parallel to the incline. Let me put a little prime just so that we distinguish it from the last case. And in doing this, our x and y now directions, when we're going to break things into components, you can see with these new coordinates that we've got normal forces exclusively in the y direction, we've got the friction force in the x direction, and we've just got one instead of two vectors to break into components.
So we're looking at now orientation axes that go along these lines.
Right. So where does this angle theta come in? We started with horizontal and vertical x and y, and we rotated through theta degrees. The x-axis has come up by theta degrees, the y-axis has come over by theta degrees. When we do this, now you can see that we've rotated our y-axis over by an angle theta, and that's taken from vertical over to the side, so our angle theta fits in here.
Now what that means is that we've got our static friction force and our normal force completely in line with the new x and y axes, and we only have to break this force of gravity into components, which in a lot of cases is going to be simpler than what we had before.
Okay, so let me just sort of list off what we've got here for you. In the negative x direction, we've got the force of static friction. No components necessary. We've got a component of gravity in the downwards or positive x direction. That would be Fg times sine theta. Those two forces cancel out. In the y direction, we've got the normal force that is strictly in the plus y prime direction. And we've got a component of gravity in the negative y direction. To get that, we would do force of gravity times cos theta. Still two equations. They sum up to zero. But in this case, we had only one component, set of components instead of two vectors. So the math is going to be easier on the finish.
Well, so let's compare these two sets of equations. If you take a look, now what we've got are entire amounts, set quantities of the static friction force and of the normal force. Much less geometry, much less trigonometry to actually solve for when we're trying to do the algebra.
Right. Newton's laws still hold. The sum of the forces in x are going to be zero. Sum of the forces in y are going to be zero.
And if you actually go through and solve both of these sets of equations in the two different orientation axes, you'll get the same numbers.
Sure. I mean, the choice of coordinate system is something we've just made up. It shouldn't affect reality.
So when it comes down to it, choose whatever's simplest for you to actually solve.
Yeah.